Finally, after waiting for such a long time for this trailer, we finally have it from Aniplex. Core 3, the trailer with the opening and ending, I believe, because there were two streams. And I think one of them was in English and one of them's in Japanese. So I think I've chosen one that is Japanese, which is the longest one, which includes the key visual. So hopefully that is correct. So a bit of a gaslight on Aniplex's part, admittedly. But at the end of the day, we have a trailer. We're going to hear the opening. We're going to hear the ending. Did already do a reaction to it, but I never uploaded it. And I quite liked the opening sound. I wasn't too sure on the ending, but that's all I know. Expectations going into this. I need some kind of confidence in Sakuga. I do need confidence because having still frames and good artwork is good. I need some confidence and bonus points for Moberuka. And considering that pre-recording this, that nobody's said anything to me on Twitter, I guess there's no Moberuka. So, oh well, let's get into this. I'm very excited to see what this is going to look like. So without further ado, hit that like, hit that subscribe, all that good stuff if you want to see more content about the game, about Bleach news, about reviews, live reactions and whatnot. Hit that link in the description down below of like the channel and of course subscribe. But with that being said, let's get into it, shall we? Clean. Is this the key visual? Or a Hibei?
Gentle.
Get a big gun, you got the spotlight, of course. And that is Jesus Christ, Orihime. Fuck. And that is a color page from the manga. That's cool and relevant. Yeah. Okay, that's nice. I love that, to be honest. That's cool. Okay, here's the opening. Do not do me dirty. Make it a good opening. Is this an AMV? Have we got an AMV for a trailer? Is this just an opening, PV? It's just an open. I'm fine with that. If it's an opening PV, that's cool. How did they make Shinji's Bankai look better in an AMV? You know? You know what I mean? Hey, I actually like this. I'm waiting for the drop. The drop's gotta hit. So far. New scene? Yes! Okay. Okay, nice camera movements there. Oh, some rolls. Is this Uryu? He's fighting Uryu. This, okay, Yuha. We're getting the actual movements of the Bankai for Ichibei? Who's it? Oh, and Ichigo versus Yuha round two? That's gonna be extended too? Who are those? Ukitake. Okay, people putting him. That's a nice rendering shot. Mayuri. Now, baby, hold my. Damn, the eye art was good there. Senjimaru's Bankai. Antithesis. Easy fight. That was probably an Ichigo fight. Panida, was that CG? X axis. Namu! Namu! Okay. The ending was good too. Sorry, I was just. Sensory overload there. October. That's a really bad time for me. But okay. So we have October. Yeah. Might be traveling then, but hey, we got October. Gassed, let's go. Of course we're going to watch it again. Of course, because I got to break down some stuff here. So let's get right into that right now. So about halfway, about 55% into this trailer, we have about probably 30 seconds of new scenes. So we're just going to give these a look and break these down, which, here we go. I can do frame by frame on YouTube, which is good. So Ukitaka's running. There's no Bankai here. So this is probably where he's fighting Lilei Barrow, obviously. Very good scene, very good way to start things off is to show the first Captain Commander. And the one thing I noticed about this scene, oh, you can see the shot fired in his, well, almost his heart, I would imagine, right? So that's cool to see. I didn't see that the first time. I did like the movements. There was a lot of actual movements, almost like he was shaking in a sense in this scene. So I did like that. It just looked really nice. See if I can replay that actually. I know it was quite a smooth transition, but a smooth transition nonetheless. And then Bankai. I guess it was leading up to that from the start of the trailer, like everyone saying Bankai, and then starting off the core three with Shunsui saying, "Okay, that's pretty cool." Okay, Ichigo coming in. Who's he fighting here? I'm gonna assume that's an Uryu fight. I don't think. No, is it maybe Uryu fight? Because that doesn't look like it's inside the castle. The castle's probably already blown up at this part. We got six loungers, the singers. So this is Ichigo versus Uryu. Some great movements here. Like, so Ichigo's been bombarded from all corners here. So I really like this scene. And yeah, just the dodging, the rolling. These are you know what this is? This is Uryu. He's planted traps just like in the Arrancar arc. Under the building floors. Would he have that pre-prep time? Probably during the battle, yeah. And Ichigo already knows because he's fought with him for so long. So that's really cool. Ichigo here. Yeah, the building's already done. You see the blue sky. He's going in for an attack on Yuha. This is after he was controlled with the Soul King. This we never ever got to see. What taking away 1,000 nights away from the Soul Society meant. This is Ichibei's Bankai, the mausoleum, the shrine, whatever you want to call it. We're finally gonna get to see what this motherfucking thing does. Oh, the CG is going crazy on this one. Wait, are those Japanese tombstones? And then the skulls. Yeah. Oh, this is. Oh! Look at the background. Those are the ropes of it goes into the shrine. The black pa is it? I don't know what type of brushing technique. Obviously, this is all digital artwork. But if they can, I mean, it looks great. It looks fucking ha exactly how I envisioned it. This looks amazing. Is this fight gonna be in black and white? I have a feeling it's gonna be in black and white with maybe the red outline. And then this is probably Ichigo's first Getsuga that we see against Yuha. So he does a Getsuga in the Soul Palace, which does blow up all of the Soul King's top part. And then there's this. So we get to see Almighty for the first time here too, and he does this move again, which is a reoccurring thing that they have in this anime. Who's he fighting? No Almighty, wait, hold on. So is this? Oh, it is different. So this is a whole different scene. This exactly looks like the Soul King's curtains behind him before he gets revealed. So no, would that make sense? Yeah, it would. It would make sense, yeah. So that looks like the Soul King's curtains. This is a whole new shot because he's got the sword. So this is his fight with Ichigo. So considering Ichigo is standing on a platform, I imagine that Ichigo did the Getsuga, blew up the top half, and then Yuha did an attack, and Ichigo probably countered it, so they've put themselves on this platform, and now Yuha's going for an attack. Are we going for like a Kano style from like episode 7 here? Nice little power up. Yuha's throwing a punch. Who are these Donnies? Oh, these are the yeah. Oh, is this different then? Oh yeah. Okay, so Ichigo. This wasn't in the manga, I don't think. The Soul King's been sliced. Obviously, we see that. Then what should transpire after that is the whole Uketake thing. But what is this? What are they doing? They're all. Oh, it seems like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so all the elite guard are giving Yuha something in the palm of his hand. Again, this is new content, right? So, oh, it's a sword. So he gives him a sword, and then he slices. That's okay. There's some timeline issues here. So it's not Ichigo's Getsuga. No, Ichigo's Getsuga only blows off a portion. So maybe it was Yuha. I have to retrace that. Shunsui, he's not a happy lad. I imagine. I don't know. I don't think these correlate. Yeah, Uketake, the Mimihagi. I do like this setting, the red and the white and the screens. They're all fighting the black orbs. I hope they all get a time to shine on this. Oh, I mean, Yeah, this is some good, like, direction. Renji looks hella skinny here. Like, toned. No, like, it's not a bad thing. But what's Renji Bankai 2? Who's he? Who's Renji fighting here? Renji doesn't go Bankai for a while, no? Someone's gonna have to probably correct that to me in the comments. I feel like this is a new scene for sure. Mayuri, baby, hold your hand. Ah, yes, I love this. Ah, with the new drip too. And you know what? I love the. Oh, you can see. That's nice. You can see the stitches on his hand from where he got his arm like contorted, and he pulled that panel where he pulls the string and he pulls his ligaments and muscles back together. That was so cool. And then I love the toad eye like psycho effect too. Then we have the black screen. So now we're getting. It does seem there's gonna be a whole tone shift, right? This obviously isn't either the new kingdom, because I know the Soul Palace changes, or this is in Soul Society. I'm gonna say it's the new kingdom. Obviously, it's black now because of the Soul King's reishi. So are we still gonna get the red? It doesn't. Wait, can I go back to Mayuri? It doesn't look red anymore. It looks purple-ish, but let's see. So we got Uri versus who? Yeah, this is a new scene. I wouldn't know. And then this should be the start of episode one, where Uryu is fighting Senju Maru's Bankai. He's using the antithesis, and you can see it in the reflection of the glasses. So, how does the antithesis work on Senju Maru's Bankai? We have some great Sakuga here with the. With a. That's a different. That's a new move, no? This? What is this? This orb. They put a lot of emphasis on it in the trailer, right? It is Hushwall. Yeah, that's new. That's very much new. Basby, obviously they're past. That's gonna have a big impact. Gerard Valkyrie just swinging at somebody. That's probably episode one. Poneida. Is this CG? This specific shot isn't CG, but Poneida's definitely getting CG treatment. For sure. For sure. Hands are a bitch to draw. And Poneida has lots of hands. But I think that's fine. I genuinely think that's fine. I think Poneida being CG. Again, CG isn't bad if they can do it correctly. Asking a. Lilaibaro. This is probably where he's trying to snipe Shunsui. Oh, the sky is black too. So this is Soul Society. That's Shunsui, but is that Lilaibaro? That's Lilaibaro, right? Yeah. That's the fight, because you can see they're on the rooftops. That's where Lilai. Oh yeah. I can see Lilaibaro's feet under. Yeah. You can just about see his feet. Yeah, that's Lilai. Is he transforming? He might be transforming here. So yeah, that's him. Now, what we're gonna do with her? That's the shot. That's the shot with the rope, right? With the string where he fucking brings. Oh, that's so cool. Yeah. Anemu, my baby girl. Oh, Anemu. This is the con. Yeah, he's holding Yuha's sword. This is the controlling. That looks cool. Ah, oh, you can see in his face. He's in agony. He's trying to fight against it and he can't. Okay, this is after. So this is after the first Getsuga. Yeah, as I said, blew a hole in the palace. So this is after the first Getsuga, right? And this is obviously later on. Amazing, fucking amazing. Yeah, this is so cool. This is the best PV. This is actually the best fucking PV that they've ever done. I'm very impressed. Well done. Well fucking done. Pyro Films. Is this Pyro Films? Also, I want to look at the staff list quite quick. So this is Pyro Films. Okay, here we go. Nice. Well, it's quite possible that I've been geo-locked, so I can't actually see the English version. So we're gonna have to go based off this. But I did notice. I think I saw a English version of the staff list, and I saw that Hiramitsu, not Hiramitsu. That's the effects director. Takahashi, Taka, yeah, and I was surprised because I thought like he was retiring this year, so I have no idea. But again, I've got, I think, Deli Chan being a chief director, I think, chief episode director. I think that that's a great promotion. Morita, do you know what? I'm gonna give him the benefit of the doubt. I really am. I am. I've seen how he can panel. I've seen the best and the bad. So this looks amazing so far. Corfree, you don't need me to validate this for you. It looks good. It looks good. We'll wait until the final product, but the music is better. The ending, I mean, I love Senna-Rin, I do, but this sounds amazing too for the ending. The animation looks great. They really look like they stepped up their games, and this is going to be the first product that Pierrot Films is dropping. So they've got to make an impact. And this PV at the moment is really shaping up to be the core. And I have said, and maybe I'm saying it prematurely, but I've said in the past, I've said, Pierrot, this is the hardest they've gone in a very long time. You need them to find their footing. At the start, they had some amazing animation. Episode 6, episode 7, episode 1, etc., etc. But they lacked in art. Core 2, they focused really good on art on a smaller timescale. And what they've done now is that they've given themselves more of a timescale and really rounded up all those bottlenecks that they've had in the past. I'm sure that there's still problems with production, but so far, they've been improving every single core. They have. Say what you want about Core 2, but the detail on Core 2 was really good. And for the time constraints that they had, and the issues that they had. So, I can only imagine that Core 4 is going to be even crazier. But tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below of what you think. I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day. Been handsome. And as always, people, peace out.